chance. On the morning of July 3rd, 1994, Tropical Storm Alberto made landfall
near Destin, Florida.
It has just been incredible here for the past hour or so. And here we take a look out over the Gulf of Mexico and look at the seas here.
The storm later stalled over central Georgia. After 86 hours of rain, widespread flooding began. The Flint River at Albany was already 20 feet over flood stage and had currents of 55 miles an hour. 31 people died, and damage estimates reached $1 billion. In June of 72, remnants of Hurricane Agnes brought devastation to parts of the Northeast. It parked over Pennsylvania. At the same time, a non-tropical system came along and captured it. Massive flooding occurred along the Susquehanna River.
Flood bulletin from the U.S. Weather Service at Harrisburg. Thursday, June 22nd. Severe local flooding is occurring in the Harrisburg area. Heavy rain is continuing and near disaster conditions are developing locally.
The flood waters rose quickly.
Don't panic, but please leave now.
Everybody up, everybody out.
Homes were submerged and people were rescued. Once the waters finally receded, mud was everywhere and fish lay in the streets. In all, 122 people died and damage totaled $3.5 billion. It's a fact that rivers can be deadly and devastating, but they also remain vital to our society's livelihood. Vivian Brown, The Weather Channel.
Well, let's see what's in store for our forecast as we head on into Sunday morning, and it looks like more wet weather, unfortunately, headed on eastward to the Ohio Valley. Lined up and, unfortunately, rain into these areas where you don't need any more rain. You've already had devastating flooding through the Ohio Valley. More soggy weather headed on in. So look out for slick roadways. Look out for the potential for flooding. And do not drive your car through any areas where water covers the roads. It can be very, very dangerous. Strong storms possible here from Nebraska to Missouri into Iowa. And we also have the chance for a bit of wintry weather. Here to the north, snow, and in the northwest, the chance for snow too. Windy conditions, rather widespread area here where wind may be a problem. The northwest, as well as through the plain states, all the way to the Great Lakes region. Winds 30 miles per hour a possibility, 3 miles per hour or more, so look out, especially high profile vehicles. And keep in mind, it could be a bit blustery out there. And fog could be a problem along the Gulf Coast and into parts of Texas. So if you're going to be out and about, take it a little extra slow on the roads because visibility could certainly be reduced. On into the forecast we go. Here's what we're expecting for Sunday morning. This area of low pressure pushing on eastward, and that's going to mean wet weather moving on into maybe Tulsa or St. Louis or Des Moines. We've got the low, we've got the front, we've got plenty of Gulf moisture streaming on in. It's going to be abundant Gulf moisture. That overriding colder air to the north is going to result in some icy conditions. That's what you see in orange. And then to the north of that, snow through Minnesota and into Wisconsin and the UP of Michigan. That moves eastward into the midday on Sunday. So anywhere along or ahead of our front, this is where you'll have the chance for rain, maybe some thunder showers. So again, St. Louis, maybe on into Tulsa, or maybe even Dallas perhaps could see some of that wet weather. But it's going to be wintry precipitation to the north where you have a little bit colder air in place. And into the afternoon, our low right over the lakes region, rain and thunder showers here. And notice that we've got that green painted on the map right over the Ohio Valley. You've had devastating flooding recently, and this is just going to aggravate the problem. Just add to it as you have the chance for an inch or more of rain in some localized areas. We think the heaviest amounts of rain are going to be here through Missouri and into Iowa, where an inch or more possible. Heaviest snow here to the north and also in the northwest, where the Cascades could pick up over half a foot of snow. So look for more wintry weather here. Here are your temperatures overnight. Lows on Sunday, chilliest in northern New England, where temperatures are going to be below zero here. High temperatures on Sunday, pretty cool to the north, but it's going to be very mild in the southern half of the country. And that forecast will take us on into Monday afternoon, where, again, the southern half of the U.S., temperatures above normal, and maybe by Tuesday, a little cooler than normal here through the Dakotas and on into Minnesota. Highs only in the 20s here, so a little on the chilly side. Into Wednesday, 70s from Atlanta to Dallas to Houston. We even have a few 90s in the southwest. And Thursday, check out these 80s here from the panhandle of Texas and Oklahoma on into Kansas. But again, a little below normal here to the north. Your highs only in the teens. Precipitation moving off the east coast for Monday. As we see that system moving off, the showers, the thunderstorms sort of scattered about the Gulf Coast, and then snow to the north. And in the northwest, another system moving in here will mean rain, some snow, some windy conditions moving out to the plain states. By Tuesday, we're going to see things fairly quiet for the southern half of the country, a few exceptions, but for the most part, that northern branch of the jet stream is going to be much more active. The systems moving along that stream are going to be the real weather makers here. Snow and wind and showery weather, also in the northwest. And we'll just continue to see the focus of our attention generally here to the north. Although in Texas, we may see a bit of a return flow here around an area of high pressure, bringing in some Gulf moisture, so that by Thursday, you will have the chance for scattered showers and thunderstorms here, snow in the northwest, windy conditions in the northeast. Stay tuned. We'll have your Pacific Outlook coming up next.
Be amazed. Caught on camera, the most incredible action-packed video you'll ever see is now available at a store near you. Watch in awe as gripping action and events unfold, all captured on tape. Take a wild ride through shocking, spectacular accidents, courageous rescues, explosive action. These graphic images.
A fast-moving storm system. Will it do any more damage? And that same storm promises a taste of winter for parts of New England tomorrow
morning. Those stories plus in-depth forecast and analysis on this edition of WeatherScope.
It's been a rainy Sunday across the Midwest. That is not good news for the flooded Ohio River Valley. Hi, I'm Kristina Abernathy. Thanks for joining us.
And I'm Sharon Resultan. We have a wintry Monday morning forecast also for the Northeast. But first, we'll take a look at some of the flooding. River communities like Troy, Indiana, did not want to see clouds in the sky. The water has just begun to recede. Troy had major flooding in 1937 and again in 64. But longtime residents say that while the water was higher back then, it rose much faster this time. And a brisk northwest wind was the only evidence in Oklahoma City that the front had passed through. The light rain ended early this morning, but winds continued to gust near 40 miles an hour. It must have thrown these guys on the golf course off just a bit. But we didn't hear any complaining about the sunshine and warm temperatures. Well, let's take a look at the current map, and we'll find indeed the front has pushed through Oklahoma City and is slowly moving through parts of the deep south. It's making a little more progress on the northern edge of the front, and that's good news. It means that we can't really tally up too much rain in one spot as the moisture is moving east of the front and the front is quickly pushing it off to the east. So we're seeing the rain pattern kind of ending around Evansville and around Cincinnati, back into western portions of Kentucky. We do find some wet weather as well, and showers and thunderstorms also back down along the front. Some of those perhaps winding down a bit now. And we'll find also the northern extent of the rain pushing up into western Pennsylvania. And even a little bit of sleet mixing in around Altoona, Pennsylvania, and around Martinsburg, West Virginia there in the Panhandle. Also saw one area in Maryland. Seeing a little bit of the sleet mixing in as well. So there may be some trouble spots heading into the north and east. First radar stop, I just wanted to get in Cleveland, Ohio here so you can see that there is still some pretty good rain across northeastern Ohio around the Youngstown area, some moderate rain being reported. And we have also had some moderate rain reported recently around the Zanesville area as well. And don't know why we skipped all the way down here, but we'll take you down into eastern portions of Texas and find more showers and thunderstorms in this particular line spreading to the south and east slowly. Again, the southern extent of the front not wanting to move quite as quickly. So it has been kind of a nasty day into eastern portions of Texas. Looking at some thunderstorms here, nothing that has been too terribly strong, so that's some good news. Heading on northward, we'll find some of the rain into southeastern portions of Arkansas, and we have had a little bit of rain into northwestern Missouri. Actually, some heavier rains across that region. The worst is pretty much over for Dallas, but there are a few showers kind of skimming south of town here. So if you're heading south on I-35, you will run into some of that, and that may cause you a few problems as we work our way through the daytime hours. And I have no idea why this is here. Obviously, we're having some sort of a little technical problem here. So let's toss it to Kristina, and she's going to tell you a little bit about the weather in the West.
And first of all, we'll start out with the Northeast, where you will be getting some wintry precipitation overnight and early Monday morning. On Staten Island, New York, this was a Sunday for the St. Patrick's Day parade. It was sunny earlier in the day, but the bright skies are deceiving. It was downright chilly to be outside watching a parade as temperatures were only in the 30s. Let's take a look. Again, you can see there were plenty of sunshine there today. We want to focus in, not necessarily on Florida. If we can, let's take a look at what's going on. Let's just advance through these and see what we can come up with here as we head. There we go. Temperatures. Let's take a look at that. Across the country, what we see are temperatures. Pretty cool in the Northeast, 33 in New York, 26 in Boston, southward fairly mild, 65 here in Atlanta, and holding in the 60s for much of the Southeast. Through the plain states behind our front, a little cooler, but out ahead of the system again, it is rather warm. In the West, we'll start you off where we've got a front moving through the Northwest, and with that, some rather windy conditions through Washington and Oregon. You've had some very gusty winds here. Still getting a bit of rain, still getting a bit of snow through the Cascades, wet weather, western Washington and Oregon. Also some soggy conditions through Idaho and into Montana. Very quiet, very nice in the Southwest where high pressure's in control. A great day for Southern California where you had plenty of sunshine and some very, very warm temperatures in the 70s and 80s around LA and San Diego. Great way to end the weekend. We will take a look at those temperatures in a little more detail here in the West, where Seattle, 45 degrees, your current temperature, 51 in Portland, 55 in Medford, and then as we head on southward, very warm still in LA at 75 and at 66 now in San Diego, cooler as we head on eastward. In the Pacific Northwest again, here's where the wet weather is, sort of a cloudy, murky day for folks in this part of the country, but we have had some snow too for the higher elevations. And again, we will see perhaps 3 to 6 inches of snow for the higher elevations here through the Cascades of Washington. What about the rest of our forecast, Sharon?
Well, we'll start you out on the weekend forecast here. Weekend's over, Sharon. Nice thinking, just dreaming here, folks. Monday morning, a brand new work week, and boy, don't you know it, here in the Northeast, wouldn't you know it, that the snow is going to begin to fall, and that's going to probably cause you a few problems across this area as far as your morning commute might be concerned. Now, many of these areas starting out as snow will be changing over to some rain across southern New England. We're going to find some showers and some thunderstorms lining up along the front here, up and down the front. And really, again, the southern extent of this just does not want to move very much. So some of those showers will meander down, say, toward Macon, Georgia by Monday afternoon. But we're still looking at kind of a wet forecast in parts of the southeast. A look again at where you might find the more significant rainfall as we head through the next 24 hours. And a look again at the lows overnight, which will be the coldest across the upper Midwest, the Great Lakes, and the Northeast. And that's exactly where you're going to find the cooler readings for your Monday afternoon. As we head into time, you're going to find that the coldest temperatures again will be across this region because the jet stream is going to be dipping southward over this area. But lots and lots of warmth here in the southeast and nearing 70 in some areas here. 80s for you into most of Florida, 70s for Dallas into Oklahoma City, and some very warm 90s heading into the southwest. Let's see how the rest of the temperatures look as we head through the week.
Well, as we head on into Tuesday, it looks like more of the same, more warmth across the southern half of the U.S. 60s, 70s, 80s, even a few 90s in Southern California. Again, as Sharon mentioned, the coolest temperatures are going to be here from the Great Lakes region into the Northeast, where you'll be in the 20s, 30s, and 40s for highs, but to the south, really couldn't ask for better temperatures. And the warmth will continue and spread northward by midweek through the Plain States. Going to be very nice all the way into Nebraska and into South Dakota. And by Thursday, the 70s, just more widespread. It's going to be, again, around Minneapolis, St. Paul, and Chicago, and Detroit, maybe New York City, where you'll have some of the cooler temperatures. But you couldn't ask for nicer temperatures from Charlotte to Atlanta to Dallas to Houston. Let's see what our precipitation is going to be shaping up like. The northern half of the country, at least as we head into Tuesday and Wednesday, is going to be more active than the southern half, with the systems moving through that northern branch of the jet stream. Snow showers here, maybe some windy conditions, snow and wet weather in the northwest. On into Wednesday, same general scenario. Where we see the changes taking place is by Thursday, where we see that Gulf moisture tapped here, so that's going to mean rain up into maybe St. Louis or Chicago, snow to the north, and where things get particularly interesting is on Friday. Take a look at this map where we have rain for the Midwest and into the Ohio Valley. We'll have to keep an eye on this. Again, the Gulf moisture is being tapped, and we could have some soggy weather once again headed to an area that doesn't need any more rain.
We'll keep an eye on that. You know, there are still some diehard skiers out there.
Yes, there are.
We're going to check on that forecast when we return.
Ready?
Sure am.
Right now, we're getting ready for the biggest brake sale in our history, the Midas No-Nonsense Brake Sale. Come in now for a thorough brake inspection, and with any regularly priced brake service over $100, you get a $40 rebate. That's right, a $40 rebate. So, stop by your Midas store today. That is, if you can. The $40 rebate ends March 30th.
This is your local forecast, weather information you can plan on, because we show it on the 8th of every hour. Local on the 8th on the Weather Channel.
There's a new Disney vacation, unlike any other, the Disney Institute. For your free video, call 1-800-682-9474 today.
You won't believe what you can do. All the things that you can try.
Imagine a vacation where you can try your hand at animation, gourmet cooking, or TV production.
Look around and you will see all the things that you can be.
Now and discover the fun of a Disney Institute vacation, a place where you can do what you've always dreamed of, plus things you never thought you'd do, all in its own resort community near the Walt Disney World theme parks. This is a limited time video offer, so call 1-800-682-9474 today.
You won't believe what you can.
I can't believe I'm doing this.
Weather. Every day, it moves and changes. There's something happening somewhere, and we bring you all of it in WeatherScope, the day's top weather stories, with live on-the-scene reports during major breaking events, up-to-the-minute forecast for the nation and specific regions, and fascinating insight that lets you understand exactly what's happening and why. WeatherScope, it's all the weather you want, every 30 minutes on the hour and half hour on the Weather Channel.
Time now. now to take a look at our skiers forecast and checking out some of those conditions across the country. And what we'll see is a bit of new snow in Stratton, Vermont and Seven Springs, Pennsylvania. Powder conditions in Stratton, Groomed for Seven Springs, as well as Stowe. You have 2 inches of new snow there. Taking a look out west, a little more impressive here, Jackson Hole, Wyoming, 8 inches with powder conditions, all trails open, and 3 new inches for Keystone. Well, here's your forecast as we head on into noon Monday, and it looks like more snow in the northwest and in the northeast. And here's your forecast for Tuesday.
Choice, the foundation of the American marketplace. When searching for insurance to protect yourself, your family, your property, or your business, an independent insurance agent can offer you a lot more choices. Independent agents are free to help you shop around. They're experienced in navigating the marketplace to find the best coverage for the right price. Look for the big eye and call today.
Independent agents representing consumers for over a century. Visit your local independent agent today.
Now, the way to save money is less people doing more work.
Time to walk out to Office Max.
It's easy to cut expenses there. Office Max has over 7,000 office products, computers, electronics, software, furniture, at guaranteed low prices. Talk about bottom line. There's great stuff like Acme frames and Vogel-Peterson chairs. You'll save so much, there'll be company cars, bonuses, and big perks for everyone. Hey, I was just kidding. Office Max, we go to the max for you.
Well, it is time now for our Florida forecast. Let's take a look at what's going on across the Sunshine State. And high pressure in control today gave you very, very nice weather for Jacksonville and Panama City, even southward to Miami. We do see a bit of cloud cover beginning to move on in to the peninsula, and also some foggy conditions here, especially in the western portions of the panhandle. But all in all, it was a very nice sunny day with just a few showers sort of scattered here and there. So again, the Sunshine State living up to its name for the most part. A look at those highs for Monday, starting off the week with 75 for a high in Panama City, 82 in Jacksonville, and on southward we go, where temperatures are going to be well into the 80s. So again, looks like a nice day, at least temperature wise. What about those water temperatures? Well, we're thinking that they're going to be ranging from 65 in Panama City to 78 for Miami Beach. And wear the sunscreen, especially in the southern half of the peninsula, if you're going to be outdoors, because the UV index is going to be rather high. Stay tuned. Your 5-day forecast is coming up next.
See ya.
Bye.
See ya.
Night, Daddy.
I go out walking after midnight, out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I go out walking after midnight.
That's bad.
What?
I took the stairs at work yesterday.
Uh-huh.
Before you know it, I'm huffing.
So?
I'm huffing.
It's a lot of stairs.
Now look at me. I eat junk. I don't work out. I'm getting my father's body.
Thousands of people have started turning their lives around with four little words. Kellogg's Complete Bran Flakes. It's a start.
You only have one heart. And as part of a low-fat, low-cholesterol diet, Complete Bran Flakes and 40 other Kellogg cereals can help you take care of it.
From the Weather Channel.
Get a wake-up call plus your local forecast. Call 1-900-WEATHER and choose option 6. 95 cents a minute.
How will you do your income tax this year?
TurboTax.
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 From Intuit, the makers of Quicken, comes TurboTax, America's number one tax preparation software.
TurboTax is the easiest way I've ever done my taxes.
Just follow these steps. Answer easy-to-understand interview questions. TurboTax reviews your return thoroughly, then prints IRS-approved forms on plain paper right from your printer. TurboTax zips you through your options, offers guidance and guidelines so you won't miss a thing. Every calculation is 100% accurate, guaranteed. With TurboTax, you'll not only save time, you can save money.
I saved over $1,000.
TurboTax found deductions that saved me over $800.
Call now. Try TurboTax free for 30 days and get Rand McNally Tripmaker absolutely free. Keep TurboTax and we'll bill your credit card after 30 days for just $39.95. So call now, 1-800-433-5333.
This is your local forecast. And stay tuned. The National Outlook is just ahead in our five-day planner.
To take you on a little tour of the nation here and talk a little bit first about temperatures. There's still going to be a bit of a chill or a bit of a nip to the air thanks to the upper level wind configuration. The northern polar jet continues to dip across the eastern part of the nation, particularly from the northeast down toward the mid-Atlantic. And Tuesday into Wednesday, that's going to allow some colder air, some colder Canadian air to sink on southward and pull on in. So the end result is going to mean some wintry temperatures hanging on from Minneapolis down through Chicago, Cleveland, Buffalo, even on into New York City and Boston. So through much of the Midwest and even into the Northeast, it's going to be just a bit on the cool side. As we take a peek now at the situation for tomorrow, we'll find that cold temperatures can also mean wintry precipitation, and we'll have that too with some snow into northern New England, and some snow will change over to rain maybe around the New York City area, on out toward Hartford and Providence, maybe even around the Boston area. We'll find showers and thunderstorms along our front here, all the way back down into south central Florida. We continue to see some of those thunderstorms in progress. And even into Monday morning, it will continue. Mostly showers, but a few embedded thunderstorms in there as well. And finally, our low pushes on off the coast, and we'll see most of the precipitation ending across the east coast by the midday hour. A few showers continuing down into Texas and along the front, maybe scooting from Atlanta back down toward Macon, Georgia. Another area of low pressure will be working its way on eastward. And as it does, we think that it will bring some more snow maybe into Detroit and Green Bay for the Monday afternoon. Fairly quiet, though, as we work our way on into the north and east. And again, did you notice something? The southern extent of the front becomes stationary. It just doesn't really want to move very much. Into South Florida, all it really means is maybe a shot at some scattered showers here and there, maybe a stray thunderstorm. For the most part, though, the day looking okay. Some snow into the Bitterroots and a new system moving into the Pacific Northwest. Here then is a look at temperatures, I believe, will come up next. Let's hope so. Nope, it's not. It's snowfall instead, but that's okay. We have to cover that ground too. And we'll be talking about some snow on the ground heading on into northern portions of New England, even into southern New England, much of upstate New York. If your commute takes you from upstate New York on into New York City, you're going to encounter some snow, and that will certainly slow you down, so you might want to plan on leaving a little bit earlier. Rainfall is a little bit heavier across this region in here, so we'll be watching for some rainy travel, maybe an inch or more in some of the rain gauges. The big problem there is really the flooding situation at hand. But fortunately, our front, as I showed you, is moving steadily on eastward. It's not going to dilly-dally. As we look at highs for Monday, again, we'll find the evidence of that trough here, and it's going to continue on into Tuesday and Wednesday. That will tend to keep temperatures in the 20s, 30s, and 40s across this entire region, with folks to your south enjoying the 60s and 70s. and even in some cases some 80s. In the desert southwest, the 90s may even be a possibility as we head through the week. 60s for you into Atlanta, Dallas, Oklahoma City, and Little Rock for Wednesday. Again, some 80s around Sarasota, back down toward Fort Myers, and Sanibel and Captiva looking good as well. Into Thursday, you'll find 70s around the Big Easy, again around Galveston and even into Houston, and some pretty nice warmth into the desert southwest. It's really just going to be the northern tier states that have to deal with the chilly readings. The rest of the nation looking pretty good. And that's great because a lot of the trees are budding and the shrubs in bloom, flowers in bloom as we head into parts of the deep south. Few snow showers here again in the Great Lakes and on into the northeast. A little bit of wind here for the Windy City. You'll find some mountain snows here into the Cascades and a little bit of rain in the valleys. As our trough deepens a little bit offshore here, some of the showers may actually spread down into San Francisco and into central portions of the Golden State. Into Thursday and Friday we go. We're going to find another situation setting itself up that more rain might be moving into the Ohio River Valley. So you'll get several days break here, which will certainly allow the rivers and streams to recede. Hopefully this particular rain event will not be a heavy one, but it's too early to tell at this time. When we return, we're going to take a look at your local forecast, and soon WeatherScope is coming up, so don't go away. We will be right back.
Now, at Long John Silver's, it's new breaded shrimp and fish. It's crispy, crunchy, and